If you don't have a Punxsutawney Phil to consult with, who do you see? Well, Rio Grande Ralph, of course.
The prairie dogs you see behind me here are actually very closely related to groundhogs. They're all members of the same family, only prairie dogs are smaller and they're from a different genus.
Prairie dogs live in burrows and do a lot of the things that groundhogs do. The thickness of their fur will tell you how cold the winter's been, so it might be okay to stretch the legend just a bit.
They came out and saw their shadows, and they did run back in, but then they came back out, probably because we put the food out there for them, and they were very hungry, so they came out to eat their food.
So they can predict the length of winter, and they can predict when it's lunchtime.
That might be a proper thing to say.
Newton says a lot of animals at the zoo are indicators, if not predictors, of the coldness of the winter. For example, the lobo wolf will grow an exceptionally heavy coat for a cold, long winter. Other older legends also say you can watch what bears or badgers do when they come out of their holes to make a prediction about the length of the winter. So groundhogs don't have a monopoly on weather predictions, and statistically they're very bad at it. However, Rio Grande Ralph does a very decent daily forecast during the winter. If Ralph is out, it's probably sunny, or it's probably lunch. Janet Blair, Action 7 News.